probably used to hold dynamite. There are some leftover wicks. Nothing else except the old wicks. Just a big heap of damp earth, nothing more. It smells of metal rust. The grate is closed with a padlock chain. I can't get rid of it with my bare hands. The right side of the lock is quite rusty. Maybe I'll be able to break it somehow. If it weren't so damp down here, I should be able to use them. There were just two bullets in the box. I must aim carefully and hit the most fragile part of the lock. A perfect shot. The padlock is down. The way is free. I did it.
This isn't looking good.
I scrambled through the vast area of the woods and set off for the castle. I was lucky today. I thought I would never make it out of the depths of the mines.
Oh, Samuel. Come, join us.
You look terrible, Samuel. Did something happen?
No, it's just that I've had a difficult day. I'm all right.
You came in rather late. I did want to have a word with you, but I have to leave for the sanatorium in a short while.
Now? At night?
Yes. There is a problem that cannot wait.
Can't you put it off to tomorrow morning?
Unfortunately, I cannot.
What's this about, then?
I do not know exactly myself. I will determine the situation when I arrive there. It must not be anything serious. You need not worry, Victoria.
Please return as soon as possible. I do not like your going there at night in this terrible weather.
It's late already. I must go now. See you tomorrow, Samuel.
Goodbye.
Be careful, Robert.
Do not fear.
I'll be leaving for Wales tomorrow, Victoria. I should return in 2 days.
To Wales? May I ask why?
Just for a visit.
Haven't seen dear Eleanor for a very long time. I will write a letter to her first thing in the morning. Will you take it to her along with my greetings?
Of course.
Thank you.
I'll go to my room now, Victoria. I need to take a rest.
Of course, Samuel.
According to William's diary, the next key has to be in the Wales Manor. I must not delay. I'll set off tomorrow.
Thank you.
I awoke, drenched in sweat today. My past memories are haunting me, even in my dreams. I should not have returned. I cleared my thoughts and decided to carry on with what I had begun. I set off for our family's manor in Wales so that I could finish what William couldn't. I hope Eleanor will not refuse my visit. I don't even know whether she'll still remember me. According to William's diary, the next key must be somewhere at the manor. I have to obtain it. However, I have no clue as to where to start looking. The grate is locked. I'll wait for a while. Maybe the ringing was too short for anyone to hear me. It seems that the wires inside barely connect. Maybe the doorbell doesn't work. I can't hear it from here. The doorbell must be broken, otherwise someone would surely have heard it. It seems that the wire... Maybe if the blade were thinner... Hello? Is anyone there? No one heard me. The upper spikes look as sharp as the lower ones. There's no going this way. The grate is locked. Damn! I have traveled such a long way, only to be barred by a locked grate. The left leg of the statue is broken off. There's a nail stuck in the column. It wasn't at all hard to pull out. I'll try to stick the nail under the doorbell so that it connects the wires. That seems to have helped. Someone's coming.
What do you want, sir? Madam Eleanor is not expecting anyone today.
I am Samuel Gordon from Black Mirror. I am here to visit Eleanor. Take me to her, please.
I'm sorry, sir, that's quite impossible.
What do you mean?
Pardon me, you said you were a Gordon?
Yes, Samuel Gordon, the son of Randall Gordon.
I'd like to trust you, but I can't. There have been some problems recently, and I've got to be very careful about who I let in. Maybe if you could prove your identity somehow, sir.
I must say, I expected a warmer reception.
I'm sorry, sir. I must insist.
I hope you will find this to be sufficient proof of my identity. It's William Gordon's mourning card. He is one of the reasons why I have come.
Of course, sir. I apologize for the disbelief. Some hoodlums tried to rob us a short while back, hence the extra caution, you see.
I understand. May we go in now?
Follow me. I'll see you inside. Pardon me, madam.
Yes, Louis. I see we have a visitor.
This is Samuel Gordon. He's come from Castle Black Mirror.
Oh, yes. I know who he is, Louis. That's all right. Is your memory failing you? I hope you welcomed our guest warmly, Louis.
I didn't know who he was, madam, and therefore I didn't want to let him in.
Welcome to Wales, Samuel. Hopefully Louis didn't annoy you too much.
No, madam. He explained the reasons for his cautious behavior.
We need to be extra careful these days. We were almost robbed last week. But that is probably of little interest to you. So why are you delighting me with your visit?
Can we speak in private?
I understand. Louis, can you return to your duties now?
Certainly, madam.
Thank you. I am so glad you have come, Samuel. I have not seen anyone from the family in years, and time passes so slowly here. Tell me, how long are you planning to stay with us?
Several days, I expect, but I don't know yet.
Only a few days? That's a pity. Victoria wrote about what had happened to William. I liked him very much. He was a great man. I regret not attending the funeral, but I am weak, and a long journey might affect my health further. I explained everything to Victoria in a letter. I hope she is not angry with me. Do you know whether she received my letter? I have not received a reply, and I do not know what to think about it.
But I have her reply here. I promised to deliver it.
Really? You are very kind. I am not keen on waiting in uncertainty. I will read it this evening. But surely you have not come just to deliver a letter.
Tell me, madam, when did you last see William?
That was a very long time ago. Yes, I do remember. He came to visit me 2 years ago, along with Robert. It was nice to see them again after such a long time.
How long did they stay?
Less than a month, I think. Why are you asking about it anyway?
I'm picking up certain pieces of a puzzle.
I see.
Do you remember any significant occurrence from that visit? Did William behave normally?
I do not remember him behaving in a... Or maybe... As I recall, he was enormously interested in our family tune. That surprised me. He seemed quite obsessed with it. In fact, he kept asking me about it all the time and finally convinced me to take him inside. I did not want anyone to disturb my ancestors' rest, but I eventually gave in. I don't know what he'd been after, though he did not want to answer any of my questions, even though I asked him directly. That day, he really did behave strangely.
William was inside the tomb. However, he found nothing, just as he recorded in his diary. I found William's personal diary, Eleanor. I read all the important records several times. He mentions the tomb you spoke about. Are you sure he did not tell you anything about it? Can you remember anything more from his visit?
Much time has passed since then, Samuel. But my memory still serves me well. He did not give me any idea why he'd been interested in that place so much. Nothing at all.
I understand. You most probably are aware of the curse that has harassed our family for so long. What do you think about it?
The curse of the Gordons? You would not believe such a tale, would you? Being a young man of the modern age, Samuel?
The chronicles state that Durgham Gordon found his final rest somewhere at this manor. Perhaps this refers to your family tomb.
I do not think so. The tomb is old, but not older than 200 years. As far as I know, the tales about Durgham reach much farther into the past. The only thing I know of him is the memorial with his name. Even if the chronicles did not lie, his grave would have certainly fallen apart a long time ago.
William knew that Durgham's key must be somewhere at the manor. I've got to get into that tomb somehow. Madam, do you know this man?
He reminds me of someone, but I may be mistaken. Am I supposed to know him?
Oh, I believe so. It's William's protege.
James! I didn't recognize him in this older picture. I only knew him as a little boy. Oh, where could he be now?
He is in Robert's care, in the sanatorium in Ashbury.
Is he still... poor lad? James was quite normal when he was young, but as he matured, that strange illness of his got worse. And he started to regress rapidly. That is why in the end, William put him in Robert's hands. Poor boy. I'm glad you told me. At least I can pray for him.
I remember the last time I was here as well. However, I'm a little surprised that you remembered me.
Of course I remember you. I have not lived here all my life. You know, I also spent some years at the Black Mirror Castle. My memory is the only thing that still serves me well. You were very young then. I can certainly understand that you would not remember the boring visits of relatives from afar.
I would also like a word with Richard. Can you tell me where I can find him?
Richard? My husband? I do not know. We barely see one another. I will tell you why before you ask. It's that damned chemistry lab of his and all those nonsensical experiments. You see, when he was young, he was an avowed scientist but never made his breakthrough. Years ago, he stopped his experiments for a long time, and I thought it was for good. But lately, the old fool has returned to those silly experiments and would rather spend his time with a microscope and formulae rather than with me.
So you don't know where I can find him?
I am angry with him right now. I'm not interested in the least what he is doing or where he is. I forbade him to carry out any experiments in the mansion, because I am afraid something might happen. If you want to talk to him, go to the old house in the garden. Most of the time, he closets himself in there with his chemicals. Surely, you will be able to find him.
May I know which room you plan to make available for me this evening?
Louis will get the East Room ready for you. It is cozy and warm. You are my guest.
Thank you. Do you know that after having traveled a whole day, I almost did not make it past your main gate?
Yes, I do. Louis did not want to let you in. You must forgive him. He's only doing what he has been told.
Oh, it wasn't just Louis. The doorbell doesn't work.
Oh, well, this whole place is falling apart. Many things do not work anymore. The mansion is slowly deteriorating. Richard does not care about these things, and I cannot manage it all alone. I'm glad I at least have Louis to help me. Without him, the garden would have become desolate a long time ago. Would you please tell Louis to fix that silly doorbell?
Certainly. Eleanor, have you ever seen anything like this?
No. What is it supposed to be?
Oh, I hoped you would tell me.
I'm sorry.
According to William's diary, an object similar to this one should be somewhere here at the manor.
I really have not seen anything like it before.
Will you allow me to examine the grounds of the mansion?
Gladly. Consider yourself at home. Just tell Louis that you are my guest.
Look at these pictures. Do the images make any sense to you?
No, I'm afraid they don't. So what do the symbols mean?
I'm not sure myself, but I hope to find out. I think I'll go now. I won't rest before the evening. I am not familiar with these coats of arms. They are not ours. Perhaps they belong to relatives of Eleanor's. Matthias Gordon, Eleanor's father. He was a famous piano virtuoso in his time. The coat of arms of the Wales branch. Our family line is much older. A common mirror, nothing special. The wood is crackling within the flames. The whole room is comfortably warm. A staircase leads to the rooms in the upper floor. I'll go to my room in the evening. I can't see inside. The glass is very dirty. Perhaps no one lives in this part of the house. The water is quite clean. No algae or mud. It reminds me of our ill-fated pond. The water is quite clean. May we talk?
What do you want?
Do you know that the bell on the main gate is not working?
Yes, I know, but I only have one pair of hands. When I've finished with other things, I will attend to it.
Well, you really should go fix it right away. It is Eleanor's wish.
Okay, I will get this done and then I'll fix it.
I think I'll go now.
Sir. That path leads to the oak garden. Visitors are not permitted back there.
Madam has given me permission, as her guest, to go wherever I please.
Oh. In that case, it's all right, sir.
The hose is fixed to the faucet with a strong wire. I'll get it off. Just turning the faucet should be enough to make the water run now. I don't need to wash anything yet. I haven't got time to sit here. Pity, though, this place is beautiful. An old water ditch. It could be quite deep. Now it's overgrown with bushes and tall grass. I'd say it has survived from the times of the old manor, just like the old grape that's bearing it. When was the last time water was running it? According to what Eleanor said, Richard should be somewhere inside this old house. It seems to be deserted. D and J.B. Fraser. These names don't ring a bell. Locked. It won't move a single inch. It seems that the key is in the lock on the other side. The staircase doesn't look very stable. The lower steps are broken. I can't go up. There's no going inside this way. These boards seem newer than the other ones on the house. Someone must have mended the hole recently. Someone dropped it here. Nothing that I would be interested in. This must be it. Durgham Gordon's tomb. I've got to get inside somehow. Part of the stone fence that the wall could no longer bear. It's sinking into the earth, saturated by the swamp. The same species as the other shrubs in the garden. This one doesn't blossom, though. Strange. Perhaps the dampness from the nearby swamp is affecting it. Who knows? A dead shrub. Nothing interesting. The grate is locked. The swamp in the rear part of the garden could be quite deep. I cannot go there. It must have been here for hundreds of years. It may be as old as the ruins of the church behind it. An old carving in the stone tablet reads, Durgham Gordon, 1523. The rest of the carving is illegible. Durgham's memorial. May we talk?
What do you want?
Louis, I'd like to have a look in the family tomb in the back garden.
There is nothing to be seen there, sir.
I'll decide that for myself. Can you open it for me?
No, sir, I can't. Madam has explicitly forbidden it. I can't let anyone in.
Surely, nothing bad will happen if you let me in. Lend me your key, and I'll bring it back in a minute. No one will find out. It will stay just between us.
Madam would certainly fire me if I broke her explicit order. I can't do anything.
Obviously, Louis won't open the grate. Oh well, at least I know who has the key. I think I'll go now. May I bother you for a moment?
You are not bothering me, Samuel. I like talking to you.
I went to the old house at the rear of the garden, as you suggested, but the door was locked.
Oh, that does not surprise me. Richard is crazy about all those tubes and flasks and treats them as if they were something valuable. Ask Louis. He brings him his meals. He probably keeps the key with him.
May I ask what that composition is that you are playing?
It is from a distant memory. I love this song. It has so much melancholy in it. If you are interested, I could play some more for you in the evening.
That would be delightful. I conveyed your message to Louis. He'll fix the doorbell by the evening.
Thank you.
I had a look at your family tomb at the end of the garden. It looks quite well preserved, unlike the ruins on the hill.
Yes, but its base is slowly sinking into the swamp. I have no idea what to do about it. The swamp is spreading more and more. In a few years, I may even see it from my window, and all those annoying insects will be flying everywhere.
Do I understand correctly that you do not wish that anyone enter the tomb? I would like to ask you to make an exception and let me in.
I'm sorry, Samuel. I really don't want anyone stepping inside. The dead deserve a dignified rest.
I understand. I won't insist. I think I'll go now. May we talk?
What do you want?
Madam told me you have the key to the old house at the back of the garden. I need it.
But I haven't got it. Madam must have made a mistake.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am.
I think I'll go now. Locked.
house seems abandoned. Some old paper. I'm not going to dirty my hands on it. Some old paper. The bottom is completely blackened, as if someone burnt something in it. These do not look like cigarette or cigar ashes. There is nothing in it. A broken oil lamp. I can't do much with it. Old advertisement papers, a page with technical literature. Two ads are marked in red. Just a few sheets of paper, some cards, and two test tubes. I don't need anything from here. I can't see. I don't need any. It's completely dirty. It's empty, just ashes. It's empty. They are no use to me. It's tightly shut. It's tightly shut. Tools for maintaining the fireplace. Just soot and ashes. Apparently, no fire has been started here in a long time. Where did it run? Where is it? It's not in the cabinet. I can't see anything there. The cabinet is too dark.